I want to take you live to Rob Morrison in Thames, New Zealand now. Rob, you followed one of these criminals back home just last night.
Yeah, that's right, we did, Melissa. We were on the flight when one of Queensland's biggest ever fraudsters, the infamous fake Tahitian Prince, was kicked out of Australia. His story, well, it's brought us here to the town of Thames in the New Zealand countryside for the final chapter in an extraordinary saga that now spans 13 years and two countries. A Border Force parade bound by a wall of burly security guards. In a sharp suit, Joel Murehu Barlow gets a homecoming fit for a fake prince.
Good to be home, Joel. It's not exactly a royal welcome.
The fraudster officially booted from Australia and pushed into the hands of New Zealand police at Auckland Airport.
Joel, would you like to say anything to the Australian taxpayers you ripped off?
On his deportation flight, no pomp, no pageantry. Just a window seat, in-flight movie, and some plain food.
Is it nice to be home? Must be nice in the jail cell.
Barlow, paraded and processed. The fake prince's return to New Zealand brings his extraordinary story full circle. He'll now live here in his old hometown of Thames, where the 44-year-old will restart his life by moving back into this home with his mother. In the quiet streets and farmland surrounds, the con artist is a long way away from the lavish lifestyle he painted, with luxury apartments, Louis Vuitton handbags and parties. As a public servant over 5 years, he fleeced taxpayers of nearly $17 million meant for charities, claiming to those who questioned him he was a Tahitian prince.
Good riddance to that false pretender.
The infamous fake Tahitian prince, the fall from his high life, now complete.
Joel, is there anything you'd like to say to Queensland taxpayers?
In Thames, Rob Morrison, 9 News.